السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
وعليكم السلام ورحمة الله وبركاته.
Today we are with Dr. Zakir Naik. Welcome Dr. Zakir in Saudi Arabia. And welcome in Jeddah. Dr. Zakir, a lot of non-Muslim people live with us, and a lot of them want to know about Islam and want to be Muslims. Dr. Zakir, we need the most important ideas and the most important advices to help them and to invite non-Muslim to Islam.
While we're inviting non-Muslims to Islam, there are various different methodologies and techniques. Some are less effective while the others are more effective.
Mm-hmm.
The most common method used by Muslims is that whenever they meet a non-Muslim, they speak 100 good things about Islam.
Mm-hmm.
But even if the non-Muslim agrees with those 100 good things, yet he will start thinking, you are the same Muslim who's a terrorist.
Mm-hmm.
You are the people who spread religion, the sword. You are the people who marry more than one woman. You are the people who subjugate the woman by keeping her behind the veil. These few negative points at the back of his mind mm-hmm. will prevent him from accepting the beauty of Islam.
Uh-huh.
That is the reason whenever I meet a non-Muslim, I ask him up front, what do you feel is wrong with Islam? With mm-hmm. your limited knowledge, right or wrong, what do you feel is wrong with Islam?
That's right, yes.
And I make him comfortable. You can attack Islam, you can criticize the Quran. And after he's comfortable, he poses about 3 or 4 questions. And these 3 or 4 questions invariably is amongst the 20 most common questions asked by the non-Muslims.
Mm-hmm.
Depending upon how the media portrays Islam, these questions arise in the mind of the non-Muslim. So if every Muslim knows the replies to these 20 common questions
mm-hmm.
with reason, logic and science, with quotation from the Quran and the other scriptures and the hadith,
mm-hmm.
even if he cannot convert the non-Muslim, he can neutralize the animosity which is there in the mind of the non-Muslim.
Mm-hmm.
And I've written a book on this.
Yes.
The common question of the non-Muslim.
Yes, that's a very famous book. Thank you so much for that, Dr.